Welcome, and thank you so much for braving the weather to be with us today. And welcome too to the people that are joining us via the power of the internet. We have our largest ever webcast happening to share this service with everybody. My name is Catherine Powell, and I am very fortunate to be one of the people that owns and operates this lovely venue. And I have with me Zoe McMillan, our wonderful crematorium manager, without whom this service and the care that we give would not be possible. Now, this is the first time, as I said, that we've transmitted to such a large number of people via the internet. And I just want to assure everyone that in the unlikely event of a technical hitch, this service is being recorded and will be uploaded to our websites so that you can revisit it should you wish, or indeed, should our signal fail, then people can then enjoy it at a later date. Our first piece of music has been chosen as a moment to gather our thoughts. It's "Someone to Remember Me" by Russell Watson.
There'll be someone to remember me.
We're here this afternoon to acknowledge the mixed emotions of this season. The pain, the joy, the sadness, and perhaps even the guilt we might feel for the moments of laughter. Perhaps you've worried that normal pleasures and unguarded moments of enjoyment might be evidence of forgetting. So this simple service is our gift to you and has three elements. Time to feel that sadness and loss. Acts of deliberate and conscious remembrance that hopefully you can feel you can reproduce at home. And encouragement to remember everything you've given as well as received when your loved ones were here in person. Next is a very familiar carol. It reminds us of this season of Christmas, but it's been chosen because it holds within it a wish for something that might, for some of you, feel a little scarce right now. Sleep, the sleep of heavenly peace. But of course, this time of year can feel anything but silent and peaceful. We're surrounded by the noise of carols and songs of jolly times, bombarded by images of happy family gatherings, something we have all enjoyed and shared. This season is wonderful for most. However, for some, each verse, each jingle, each supermarket advert only highlights loss, absence, and grief. We've placed this empty chair here today as a symbol of this sense of loss, and to acknowledge the dear ones that will not take their place at the festive table, to acknowledge the silence left by the absence of their laughter, and a heartache that dims the bright lights. And our next song is Someone Is Missing at Christmas.
Someone's right here in my heart. Christmas can be a very difficult time of year, remember this. A heart that's been broken is a heart that has known love. The first Christmas after you lose someone close to you can be particularly hard, with conflicting emotions, challenges, and questions. Do you attempt to embrace the festivities of the season in a new and different way? Do you find comfort and solace in preserving family traditions as a tribute to your loved one, both now and for the future? Some may decide not to celebrate at all, while others will be swept along with celebrations for the sake of children and those around them. But it can hurt. I know from my own experience that it's important to be kind to yourself and that you will get through this. You may even smile through tears as that certain song or family tradition triggers waves of happy memories that wash over your soul and soothe your heart.
Now we come to our first act of remembrance. Candles have been an aid to meditation and reflection since ancient times. They can be a gesture of prayer. They can be a gesture that we use in private, in public, at home, or in a place of worship. A small light in what might feel like a vast darkness. As we light each of these four candles, those watching via the online webcast can join in too, if they wish. The first candle represents our grief. The pain of losing someone is intense, but it reminds us of the depth of love that we feel.
This second candle represents our courage to confront our sorrow, to comfort each other, to change our lives.
This third candle we light in memory for the times we laughed, the times we cried, the times we were angry with each other, the silly things you did, the caring and the joy you gave us.
This fourth candle we light for our love. We light this candle that your light will always shine as we enter this festive season and share this night of remembrance with our family and friends.
We cherish the special place you have in our hearts that will always be reserved for you.
We thank you for the gift your living brought to each of us.
We love you.
We remember you.
And I will lie. Shatter all the darkness and bless the times we knew. Like a beacon in the night, the flame will burn bright and guide us on our way. Oh, today I light a candle for you. Seasons come and go, and I'm weary from the change. I keep on moving on, you know it's not the same. And when I'm walking all alone, do you hear me call your name? Do you hear me sing the songs we used to sing? And I will light a candle for you to shatter all the darkness and bless the times we knew. Like a beacon in the night, the flame will burn bright and guide us on our way. Oh, today I light a candle for you. You filled my life with wonder, touched me with surprise. I always saw that something special deep within your eyes. And through the good times and the bad, we carried on with pride. I hold on to the love and life we knew, and I will light a candle for you to shatter all the darkness and bless the times we knew. Like a beacon in the night, the flame will burn bright and guide us on our way. Oh, today I light a candle for you.
There are wonderful songs for every occasion, to express our feelings, to match our mood, and this situation is no different. Our next song, performed by Betsy, "Miss You Most at Christmas," is our moment to acknowledge and express our feelings, but also to remember that we are not alone. Someone wrote this song. Someone was inspired by their own situation to put words and music together, which means that others have walked this path too.
Most of Christmas.
Thank you, Betsy. That was absolutely beautiful. But we can't leave things there. Life goes on, and Christmas will come around each year. So let's find ways to bring the ones we miss from our Christmas past into our Christmas present. The tree could be called the heart of Christmas, and you can transform it into your family tree. A message tag or special bauble mean that remembering becomes part of your daily festivities. Those here with us have had the opportunity to write a message of remembrance on a gift tag, and in a moment we will invite you to come up and place these on the Christmas tree. This is something that you can do at home too.
One of the people attending here this evening brought with them a poem. And this seems to be the perfect moment to read it to you. The title is Miss Me But Let Me Go. When I come to the end of the road and the sun has set for me, I want no rights in a gloom-filled room. Why cry for a soul set free? Miss me a little, but not too long. And not with your head bowed down. Remember the love that we once shared. Miss me a little, but let me go. For this is a journey that all must take, and each must go alone. It's all part of the Master's plan, a step on the road to home. When you are lonely and sick of heart, go to the friends we knew and bury your sorrow in good deeds. Miss me a little, but let me go. I think the tree looks absolutely beautiful with those messages of love. Thank you. There are other symbols of Christmas too. Bells. People across the world use bells in many different ways. Each chime making sound waves that travel across space and time. Some for warning, some for sorrow. To give the lost a voice, a call to prayer. For remembrance and for celebration. Some of you may be familiar with my favourite Christmas film. It's A Wonderful Life, which has become a Christmas classic. The main message is incredibly important and moving and touches me every time. The message that even the humblest, most ordinary seeming life can change the world. But there's more. In this film, a little girl, Zuzu, tells her father that every time a bell rings, an angel is being given their wings, which is a truly lovely thought. We are now going to pass two bells among you and invite you to hold your loved ones in your thoughts as you ring that bell for them, sending your love on the sound waves of their chimes. And we hope that their bright sound will lighten your hearts and lift your spirits.
Please join us in this Christmas blessing. At the end of each phrase, we may all say the words, "We remember them." In the preparation of celebrations and the coming together as family,
we remember them.
In the decoration of the Christmas tree and in the sending of Christmas messages,
we remember them.
In the carving of the turkey and the raising of glasses,
we remember them.
In the celebration of Christmas and in the ringing in of the new year,
we remember them.
when we are weary and in need of strength.
We remember them.
When we are lost and sick at heart.
We remember them.
When we experience joys we yearn to share.
We remember them.
As long as we live, they too shall live, for they are part of us, as we remember them.
It's very easy to simply focus on what this special person did for you. But that is only part of their story and only part of yours. It's important to remember what you gave them too.
Find comfort in the knowledge that you had a profound impact on their lives too. That their lives would not have been the same had you not been in it. Think about how you seeped into their hearts and enriched their lives, how your presence in their lives was a gift, and how you made their days lighter, brighter, and happier.
Recalling how you enriched each other's lives reminds us that love makes an unbreakable connection. The love you still feel pours out. Remember all the moments you have shared and find your own ways to bring that remembrance into your life. And as you share a loved one's stories with others, this golden thread of love will weave itself into the tapestry of your life forever. And here is a short poem of encouragement. It's called Beyond the Empty Chair. Look beyond the empty chair to know a life well spent. Look beyond the solitude to days of true content. Cherish in your broken heart each moment gladly shared, and feel the touch of memory beyond the empty chair.
I'd like to thank you all so much for joining us this afternoon. Looking out, I can see familiar faces, so many familiar faces, all gathered here today in memory of those that you have loved and lost. I would like to take this opportunity to say that my team and I consider it a huge honour to have been entrusted with the care of your loved ones. We hope that by coming together here today in this special place and in this very special way, that we have helped you to see that you are not alone and that others walk this path too. We hope that by being together today, you will find comfort and strength. Just as our candle symbolised the light of love that can never be extinguished, may you see this light in yourselves and in others, so that together you can reach a place of peace, calm, and healing. As we come to the end of our service this evening and return to our daily lives, be gentle with yourselves. It's okay to be sad. But it's also okay to feel happiness, to smile and to laugh. Let your hearts delight in the warmth of those who gather around you and allow yourself to be embraced by the goodwill of the season. Let's rejoice in the knowledge that lives that have been loved are lives that were well lived. Our closing song, The Parting Glass, expresses this beautifully. And please join us afterwards to raise our own parting glasses to celebrate the ones that have brought us here today.
Of all the money that e'er I had, I spent it in good company, and all the harm I've ever done, alas, it was to none but me. night and joy be to you all. So fill to me the parting glass and drink a health, whate'er befalls. Then gently rise and softly call, good night and joy be to you all. Of all the comrades that e'er I had, they're sorry for my going away, and all the sweethearts that e'er I had, they'd wish me